People miss out on opportunities to inject more flavour into rice because they just think, you know, it's just rice, it's plain. But I'm going to add some butter. I'm just going to let that melt and foam a little bit before I add the rice. And the rice, I've added a little bit of turmeric for some nice colour. So I'm going to do buttered chicken. I'm so excited about this because I wanted to learn how to cook it for the longest time and I finally confronted my fears. And it's actually not that hard. So to start off with, we've got chicken thighs, okay, already skinned. And I cut those into chunks. And then what I'm going to do is actually just score each piece so that that marinade can penetrate perfectly through that flesh and make it really, really tasty. Next, I'm going to make the marinade for the chicken.
And it's a mixture of Greek yogurt with lemon juice, garam masala, chili, salt, and sugar. And it goes into a snap-lock bag with the chicken.
So this is completely from scratch because there's lots of sort of cheap versions where you buy tandoori paste and rub it on the chicken, but I really wanted to know how to do it from scratch all the way. And let it marinate for 2 hours minimum and overnight for a really, really good result.
Now the rice.
I think a lot of people miss out on opportunities to inject more flavour into rice because they just think, you know, it's just rice, it's plain. But I'm going to add some butter. I'm just going to let that melt and foam a little bit before I add the rice. Rice is actually the second most Googled item on how to cook next to quinoa. So I'm going to teach you a really fail-safe way. It's 1 cup of rice to 1.5 cups of water. That's it. And the rice, I've added a little bit of turmeric for some nice colour. So stir that through until that yellow is really nicely distributed through the rice. And because we've got 2 cups of rice in here, what is it? It's 3 cups of water. In that goes. Just cold water. I'm going to stir that around and then bring that to the boil. While that's boiling, we're going to get on with the wet spice paste,
which is ginger, garlic, onion and green chilies with just a dash of water.
I'm going to pretty much puree that. What I've got here is some butter. Just going to melt that butter until it's foaming a little bit. And then I'm going to add ground cumin,
along with coriander, cinnamon, and cloves.
So I'm going to stir that around until the ground spices are kind of fizzing a little bit. I know it sounds like a weird description, but it does. Kind of foams up and you can smell it getting really toasty and fragrant. And that is your cue to add the next bit, which is the wet spice paste we've just made. I can see my rice is already boiling, so I'm just going to give it a little bit of a stir and turn that right down to the smallest, smallest simmer you can possibly get it to, and then pop the lid on. 15 minutes. Do not touch it, do not open the lid, okay? That's already smelling so delicious. Okay, that's good. And next we're going to add chili.
And black pepper, fenugreek seeds, nutmeg, bay leaves.
And then I'm just going to crush these in my hand, they're little cardamom pods, just to sort of help the flavour be released from the pods. Beautiful.
Then in goes the tomato paste and puree and Greek yogurt.
So that is your sauce pretty much done. How simple was that?
And now for those beautifully marinated chicken thighs.
So I'm just going to bake them. Very easy. To accompany the butter chicken, I'm going to make a raita. I just love them because they're so nice and refreshing.
And it's simple. Grated cucumber is squeezed out and mixed with Greek yogurt, lemon juice, chopped mint and a touch of salt, and sugar. Done.
All right, so your chicken's done. And we're just going to pop that into the pot. And then I'm going to add a little bit of honey because you do need a tiny bit of sweetness in that. and then cream. A lot of people would say don't add the cream yet, but because we're going to have it on a low simmer, it's absolutely fine. You just don't want to boil cream. Beautiful. And let that simmer on the lowest heat for about 1 hour. So you can walk away completely. Meanwhile, the rice, as soon as the rice is finished cooking, you do want to fluff it up. Because what you'll find is more and more of the steam evaporates and it cools down, it'll sort of start to sit in one giant clump. Beautiful. That's ready to go. So we'll just leave that there, pop the lid on to keep that heat in. That's pretty much it.